Oh, look at this. We're joined right now. Is that Kate on our Zoom?
I'm here.
Kate Del Castillo, how are you?
I'm great. How are you, Ryan?
I am fantastic. It's so nice to see you. We've got Patty and Sissany and Tanya all on our Zoom.
Hi.
Hi, Tanya. Hi, everyone. Hi. I'm like just on my phone, you know, checking whatever, Instagram, my emails, whatever. And suddenly I see you. It's like, oh, shit.
Oh, yeah. But I'll send you an Instagram as well. You can see me there, too.
Exactly. How do you do, Ryan? How do you do being in New York and L.A.? I'm a big fan of Kelly, too. So I'm happy to see you. Thank you.
Thank you. I do it by living on an airplane, and that's pretty much. But since this lockdown, I've not had to fly.
Well, that's good. Good for you.
And what about you? What have you been keeping yourself? I know you got some big news coming up, but what have you been doing otherwise?
I know. I've been here. I've been at home. You know, I also travel a lot. So for me, it's been amazing to be in my home, you know, taking advantage of my home, being and on summer in my home. It's been like probably 3 or 4 years that I haven't been able to be home in summer. So for me, it's amazing. It's like a little vacation for me. And I'm good. I live alone. I've been alone for a long, long time. So I'm not scared of being alone. That's the least of my problems. My problem is that I don't have someone to get in touch with, you know, the human touch. You know, Mexicans, we hug and we are always on top of each other. So for me, that's being a little, you know, challenging.
So that's interesting. You live alone. I live alone, but I don't like being alone.
You don't?
No. I like someone around. Like, I'm not a good lone person. You know what I mean?
Okay, so I can be around if you want me to.
All right. All right. Listen, I now have a famous companion. How about that?
Nice.
That's so cool.
Perfect.
All right, let's get into some business here. Seasons 1 and 2 of La Reina del Sur were very popular, and they're so popular, they're now rolling over to Netflix, right?
Yes, we're in Netflix since the first one, yes.
So did the first two seasons were on Telemundo?
Yes, it was Telemundo, the first season. And then after 10 years, we did the second season, which was really weird. It was so big and it was so successful after 10 years, which I thought it was, you know, everybody should have just forgotten about the first season and about La Reina del Sur, Teresa Mendoza and all the thing. But it was amazing also second season. And now we have to be even better than the second season.
So your character, a woman from Mexico, becomes the most powerful drug trafficker in southern Spain.
Yeah, southern España. It's sur de España, which, yeah, that's why she's called La Reina del Sur, porque es la reina del sur de España. So, yeah.
And so where do you shoot it? Do you shoot it in Mexico? Or
oh, my God, no. We were based in the first one, we were based in Colombia, and we traveled a little bit. But the second one, we were based in Colombia. I couldn't go back to Mexico back then because I had a little problem with Mexico and the whole Chapo gate, that I call it. So I couldn't go back to Mexico. So we were based in Colombia, but we went to Russia. We went to 8 countries, Russia, Romania, Spain, Italy, Mexico, not me, but the crew went there. We were all over the place and it was amazing. So now for the third one, it's going to be a little bit challenging because I don't want to sacrifice the story or the production.
Right.
Having to go and travel everywhere with the pandemic, you know? So we're going to have to wait a little bit so we can do it, travel in a wise and healthy way, you know, for all the crew.
For sure. Well, it's so exciting that it continues to be successful. You know, Patty introduced me to the series and then told me about the big
movie on Netflix. I love Patty.
Hola, amiga. I love you so much.
¿Cómo estás? No, thank you. I remember, I will never forget, Ryan, that the first time I got here, well, not the first time, but I was early here, probably 15 years ago, and you and Eva Longoria, great friend. I know you love her and I love her as well. And you interview me for La Misma Luna, Under the Same Moon, that movie. And I felt so welcomed, you know, coming from another country. I left everything there. I started from scratch here, a new career, everything. So for me, it was amazing that you guys, you know, were so nice with me, and you guys loved the movie. So I will never forget that. Thank you.
Well, you are so sweet, and I'm so happy. I will never be alone again. Thank you very much, Kate Del Castillo, for being on this show. Take care, all right? We'll see you soon.
Thank you so much. Gracias, Patti.
Love you, baby.
Bye. Adios.
Bye. Well, Patty, what's El Chapo Gate? Is she?
Wait, you know the story. It was like the biggest story all over the country.
Did she do the series I watched? Was that
she
her?
Had dinner with him?
Yes.
And then the FBI and the DEA and the Mexican government and army and everything. Just everyone found out, and then Sean Penn got involved.
Was she with Sean Penn?
Yes.
She took Sean Penn down.
She took Sean in?
Yes.
Get her back.
They both flew down there to have dinner with Chapo.
I remember too.
But was she not allowed to go back to Mexico?
For a while, she was not allowed during the last presidency. She had to wait for the turnover.
I didn't see the whole thing, but it's on Netflix, right?
Yeah, she has a documentary on what happened, and it's so good. She is so badass.
I like her.
I love her.
I'm happy
she's
that
she's not afraid of anything.
No,
like,
I could see the way
down.
She was sitting. You see the way she was
sitting?
Yeah. She was sitting in tattoos and the whole nine.
With her legs up on the chair, cross-legged.
But she went to go with Sean Penn into some undisclosed location?
Yeah, because the idea was to get an exclusive interview for Rolling Stone magazine, remember? That was Penn's agenda.
But
she didn't even know what was happening.
Is that how they ended up catching
him? That's how they caught him.
How'd I miss that whole conversation with Kate? I want to know more about...
It sounded like she didn't want to touch too much on
it. Well, she called it El Chapo Gate, but that would have been scary. Right?
Oh, good.
Wow. I'll watch that on Netflix too then.
Yeah.